Good day, YouTube. Using these Lightroom fundamentals, we can take images that look like this and turn them into this. Grab a cup of coffee and stay tuned. The first image I want to process with you guys was actually from my intro video. I took it this week actually when it was pounding snow all night and into the morning, creating these wonderful conditions for photography. I had the flowing river, it wasn't frozen, there was wildlife and the snow was falling and it created this natural haze, and because it was still early, there's all this like crystalline frost on the trees. It was wonderful. Let's head into Lightroom and take a look. Okay, so we're in Lightroom now. And the only thing I have done to this raw image here is I've despotted it with the spot healing tool just to clean it up a little bit. So we're going to do four things to this image. The first thing is we're going to do our foundational edits like white balance and camera settings. The second thing we're going to do is increase the vibrance in the image to increase the perception of the fainter color hues in the image. Next, we're going to play around with the clarity slider in order to increase the perception of that snow atmospheric haze created by the falling snow. And then lastly, we're gonna do some dodging and burning so that we can increase the amount of depth in the image. We're gonna really work to darken the foreground. Okay, so first thing we wanna do is decide what camera profile we're gonna use. And for me personally, I find that my Nikon V300's camera standard profile works a lot better than the Adobe Color, but you gotta play around with it because your mileage may vary with your camera. So I'm gonna go ahead and go there. And then the next important adjustment we have to make is we have to decide what the white balance we wanna use is. And for winter photography, there's really no set rules. It's just a matter of what kind of emotions you wanna get across in the image and what you value, what is important. We can try using as shot. The next thing we could do is we could click this auto here and see what that looks like. And that tends, with winter photography, that function typically tends to lead to a warmer image, as we can see here. I think it's a bit warm for my taste. And the other thing we can try is this white balance selector. And we can look for a neutral white part of the image, the snow being the perfect candidate for that. And we can click that and Adobe Lightroom will attempt to neutralize that color into perfect white. And that gets us to a bit more of a balanced image. Yeah, it's less warm. It's still warm, but it's less warm. Now, this is simply a starting place. So there's no set rules. So we can start here and we can mess around with the temperature and the tint and see if it produces a result to our liking more. So if we slide this to the left here, it's going to bring out the cooler hues in the image and really bring out the icy nature of the photograph, as we can see here. And if we go to the right, we're going to get all those warm colors to come out more. So it's really just a matter of personal taste. For this image, I kind of like it leaning in the warmer direction. So I'm going to go with that. I'm just going to bring it back to what the white balance selector decided. All right, so the next thing we can do here is this image, we don't really have a lot of very strong colors. The only thing that's producing color is just this grass here that we can see coming out through the snow. And sometimes if we go ahead and apply saturation to that, it makes things a bit stronger than what we really want. With photography, it's often not the total saturation that creates a fantastic perception of color. It's often the contrast between color that's most important. Our eyes just want to see contrast between the various colors. And so because we have all these faint hues we want to bring out, we can actually use the vibrance slider. And what vibrance does in Adobe Lightroom is it increases the saturation of the fainter color hues in the image. So let's go ahead and adjust that. Let's increase that. And so increasing, yep. And I think about 30 is quite nice without being too strong. There we go. So that's gonna just bring out the color a little bit more without making it look unnatural. Just brings more character to the image. All right, so the next step here, what I really want to do is increase that perception of that natural haze created by the snowfall. And the way we can do that is by messing around with the clarity slider, specifically reducing clarity. Now, often with the clarity slider and in image processing in general, we feel that strong urge to want to increase because we want to make things more bold. We want to make things stand out. You know, with clarity, we're going to get more local contrast specifically because that's what clarity increases. And we can do that here. And I don't hate that. I like that. It makes, you know, all the white snow on the trees really poke out and we get more contrast in general. And the fine, you know, the lines on the river are really showing up. But for this image in particular, I want to do the counterintuitive thing here and actually reduce the clarity. So I'm going to go ahead and start doing that. And as I pull this down, we can start to see that natural haze is coming out. Wow. See, I think that just looks absolutely beautiful. That natural fog created by that reduced clarity. So if we look in the distance here, we can still see that the white snow on the branches is still poking out. Yeah, wow, we just get this very ethereal-like artistic element to the image. And I just think that that works so well with winter photography, in particular when it's snowing. All right, so the last thing I want to do to this image is apply some dodging and burning techniques to increase the sense of depth in the image. So what I want to do specifically is decrease the brightness of the foreground river here just a little bit so that as we look into the river, as we look into the frame, we get a slight increase in brightness, adding to that sense of three-dimensionality. So in order to do that, I'm going to go over to this masking category here on the right with the circle icon, and I'm going to select the linear gradient option here. And what that does is it adds a line shape gradient to the image that we can apply to the foreground. So we can add it by clicking on the image and dragging the cursor. And I'm going to first orient this exactly how I want it. So if we move the center here, it changes the position. And if we click to the left of the center, we can now change the rotational orientation. And if we click the top here, we can drag it up and down to increase or decrease the length of the gradient. And apply it about here. Perfect. So now that the gradient has been applied with an increased effect as we come into the foreground, I'm going to go to the exposure slider here and just pull the exposure down a little bit, decreasing the brightness. Now, if we do this too much like this, it's going to look unnatural and weird. I want to apply just a slight effect. It's slight, but it is very powerful. So yeah, maybe around like negative 0.5. There we go. So now I darken that foreground of the river a little bit, adding a bit of depth. Yep. All right, one last quick final adjustment to this image. I want to increase the whiteness on the snow so it stands out just a little bit more. And the way we can do that is we can go over into the adjustments category and go to the whites here and increase the whites, increasing the brightness of the snow. So I'm going to go ahead and apply that effect slightly, not too much. Yeah, it's too strong. So probably around 40. Yeah, about 40. There we go. So now the snow is just standing out and poking through the haze just a bit more. All right, so this is the final image. This is Platte River in Colorado during the midst of a snowstorm. Let's get on to the next image. All right, so the second image here I want to process with you guys was also taken in Colorado's Platte River, but it was taken on a different day with a different snowstorm. And on that particular day, it snowed really hard during the evening and it cleared up by the morning. And I went out right away in the sunrise and I got that natural, soft, warm glow from the sun. And that crystalline frost was there on the trees because I hadn't waited too long for that to dissipate. And frankly, I think that's some of the best time to do winter photography, like right in the morning after it snows. It just produces such beautifully radiant photographs. All right, so let's get into Lightroom. All right, so the first step here is just like the last one is we're going to set the camera profile how we want it. I have it set to camera standard for my Nikon D300. And secondly, we want to adjust the white balance to our taste. So I'm going to play around with this image a little bit. I'm going to try auto. Yeah, and I think that produces an image about exactly where I want it, but I'm gonna try the white balance dropper here and pick a neutral area and turn it into white. Yeah, you see, I think that's a bit cooler than I want it to my taste. It brings out the icy cold characteristics of the image too much. And go back to auto and play around with that a little bit. Try making it a bit warmer. Yeah, it's a bit too warm and it's a bit too cool. Okay. So I think the auto setting for this image produced it just right. 7,500 is our temperature. All right, that's good. All right, so the trick here to make this image really stand out is we want to really bring out that natural warm glow from the sun without increasing the saturation of other colors, particularly blue, and making those colors too strong. So there's really two ways we can go about this. The first way is we could go down to this HSL section here, which stands for hue, saturation, and luminance. And we can increase the colors that we want, and that most often works. So we can go increase the oranges a little bit, you know, we can increase the yellows. However, for this particular image, I actually found doing it a different way to be even more effective. And so what I want to do is just start by increasing the global saturation of the image, increasing the saturation of all colors. And when we do this, as you're going to see, it's going to make the blues look absolutely crazy and insane. But that's okay. So we're going to start here. Yeah, so this really brings out the orange and the yellow, but the blue is way too strong. So we can go back down to the HSL slider and we can target the blues specifically and pull them back. There we go. All right, I think that's just perfect. All right, so just like the first photograph, with this photograph, we can also increase the sense of depth and three-dimensionality of the image by doing some dodging and burning. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so what I want to do is I want to make this lake here just a little bit darker. And I want to do that without affecting the snow around the lake. So we can do that with making use of the intersect tool within Lightroom. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this linear gradient tool and I'm going to make a linear gradient here and I'm going to apply it just to this lake area. Got to line up the orientation just right first. I'm going to lengthen the gradient a bit. There we go. Now, as you can see, the effect is being applied to the snow. So the way we can get rid of that is we can go and make another mask on top of this mask. So there's these three dots right here. We can click that and we can click intersect mask width. So I'm going to click the brush tool. Now the brush tool is an extremely powerful tool within Lightroom and we can really target any part of the image we want by brushing on that effect. So I want to target this lake here, so we're going to be very careful and we're going to draw in the lake. And as you can see, the linear gradient is still applied because as we go towards the bottom left corner of this image, that effect is being applied more strongly. All right. So now we have the exact mask that we want. So we can go here and pull down the exposure just very carefully. One more time. There we go. So now the lake is just a little bit darker. All right, so the next thing here is I want to do the exact opposite thing to the trees, and I want to make the trees and the whiteness on that tree is just a little bit more luminant without increasing the brightness of this bottom right corner here because the snow is already pretty bright. So I'm going to go ahead and say create new mask. And I'm going to create another linear gradient. We're going to apply this gradient to the top right of the image. There we go. So now that the gradient is applied, I'm going to go to whites here, and I'm going to increase the whites to really increase the luminance on that crystalline frost on the trees. I think, yeah, right. 18 is where I had it. Okay, so now there's this very distinct polarization between the right, top right of the frame and the bottom left of the frame. So one last thing is we can add a third mask here. And I'm going to use the brush tool for this one. And I want to increase the contrast on this ridge here just to make it a little bit more strongly outlined. So I'm going to go ahead and very carefully draw in some of this effect around this ridge. And then we can go ahead and go into the contrast right here and try that. There we go. Don't want to do this too much. Just very slight. It's a very slight effect. All right. 15. That's about perfect. Okay. So this is how I went and processed this photograph. This is our final image. All right. I hope you found this tutorial on Lightroom and winter photography extremely helpful and valuable. If you did, like my video in the box below. And if you'd like to see more content like this in the future, subscribe to my channel. And lastly, if you'd like to check out some of my photographic work, where I've also done astrophotography as well, check out my website in the description below. Thanks for taking some time to tune in, and have a wonderful day.